If you've ever felt like your body runs out of fuel before your day even begins, this video is for you. For people with ME/CFS, fibromyalgia, and long COVID, that deep, unrelenting fatigue isn't about motivation or mindset. It's cellular. It starts with energy metabolism. In this video, I'm going to walk you through a well-researched, widely available supplement, creatine, that may offer real support for mitochondrial function and fatigue. No hype. Just the evidence. I'm Dr. Courtney Craig. I've lived with ME/CFS for over 25 years. I'm a clinician, nutritionist, and educator. My article on creatine has gotten more attention than any other post I've written, and for good reason. Let's look at why creatine may be relevant for post-viral conditions, what the research says, and how to use it safely. Most people associate creatine with athletes and weightlifting. And yes, it does help improve strength and recovery. But in recent years, research has uncovered a broader role. Creatine as an alternative energy buffer when mitochondria are under stress, and as a stabilizer of mitochondrial function. It can even act as a modulator of inflammation and oxidative stress. So this makes it worth examining in illnesses marked by mitochondrial dysfunction, like post-viral conditions. So let's look at each of these aspects in a little bit more detail. In post-viral illnesses, your mitochondria can behave like factories running on rolling blackouts. Energy production stalls, calcium floods the cell, and oxidative stress builds. Even simple tasks then can feel like running a marathon. Creatine acts like a backup generator. It stores phosphocreatine, which helps rapidly recycle energy, ATP. But energy is only half the story. There's also something called the mitochondrial permeability transition pore. This pore functions like a safety valve. It briefly opens to help regulate calcium levels and oxidative stress. However, if this valve gets stuck open, it disrupts the mitochondrial membrane, leading to leaking of vital molecules and triggering pathways that culminate in death of the cell. Creatine helps stabilize this pore, and it also supports something called cardiolipin, which is a molecule that functions like scaffolding to help electrons move across the mitochondrial membrane and make energy, ATP. The result? Fewer leaks, steadier energy, and better tolerance to daily activity. Here are some key findings from research studies. A 6-week trial using creatine in ME/CFS patients showed increased brain creatine and improved fatigue and cognition. In long COVID, creatine trials showed symptom improvements in fatigue, brain fog, and breathlessness. In fibromyalgia, creatine improved muscle strength, quality of life, sleep, and pain when used alongside standard treatments. Now, these are small studies, but the results are consistent and worth paying attention to. We also have evidence that creatine metabolism may already be impaired in these conditions. Brain imaging showed abnormal creatine levels in ME/CFS and fibromyalgia. Research from the UK ME/CFS Biobank revealed that individuals with severe ME/CFS exhibited significantly lower serum creatine kinase levels when compared to healthy controls and milder forms of the illness. Now, creatine kinase is an enzyme that's critical for energy production in muscle cells, and its reduced levels may reflect impaired muscle energy metabolism. Another study showed increased levels of creatinine, the breakdown product of creatine, in urine samples from ME/CFS patients. This suggests a higher turnover of creatine, and that the body may be utilizing and breaking down creatine at an accelerated rate. These findings collectively point to a heightened demand and altered handling of creatine, underscoring the potential of creatine supplementation as a supportive strategy. Most studies use creatine monohydrate, which is a well-studied and affordable option. The typical dose is 3 to 5 grams per day. It's best taken with a small amount of carbohydrate, like juice, to enhance absorption and reduce digestive irritation. If you're sensitive, start with a small dose and increase gradually. Side effects are generally uncommon, but it can cause digestive distress. Creatine has also been shown to affect immune cell function, including macrophages and T cells. And for this reason, some individuals with ME/CFS may experience temporary symptom flares when starting creatine, something similar to a Herxheimer reaction. Start low and go slow. That approach is always best. Creatine isn't something to ignore. It's one of the few supplements that directly targets mitochondrial energy production, and the research so far is very promising. For many, it may offer a safe, accessible way to support energy metabolism, and it's also one of the most inexpensive supplements out there.
If you found this helpful, be sure to subscribe to the channel or share the video with someone else navigating similar challenges. Let me know in the comments if you've tried creatine and how it went for you. If you want deeper guidance, check out my nutrition courses for post-viral illness and other free resources on my website, which is linked below. And I'll see you in the next video.